Hello, and welcome back to Brain Health Today. I'm Nicole Fisher, I'll be your host, and I'm really excited to welcome today's guest, Dr. Patricio Reyes. Dr. Reyes is the director of traumatic brain injury, Alzheimer's disease, and cognitive disorders at the Phoenix VA, as well as chief medical officer of the retired NFL players. Welcome to the show.
Thank you, Nicole.
So I'd like to start with a very broad question. So the two titles I just said, VA and NFL players. Can you tell us a little bit about the similarities between those two groups of people?
Yes, it's very interesting because both servicemen and women and NFL players may suffer from mild traumatic brain injury. This usually refers to concussions and what we call subconcussive events. And it is now believed that a series of concussions and subconcussive events could lead to a chronic neurologic disorder called chronic traumatic encephalopathy, which is actually a similar syndrome described several years ago in retired boxers known as dementia pugilistica.
So we now refer to this as CTE, as you said, and we're starting to hear this term all the time, whether it's in the world of neuroscience, the world of sports, and I know you've been working on some grants, trying to look at different parts of research with the brain. Can you tell us a little bit more about what it is that you're working on?
Well, I think we need to understand better what happens to the brain in concussion, in mild traumatic brain injury. We now know that at least 80% of the casualty of the war on terror is due to mild traumatic brain injury.
Wow, that's shocking.
In addition, a significant number of our casualty suffer from PTSD and depression. So those three things, traumatic brain injury, PTSD and depression, are the subject of our grant.
Excellent, and I think it's so important that you bring up depression. This is something I think that's not often described as a problem in and of itself, as well as a symptom of other things that are going on. So in your past, I know that you've worked for some biotech companies, you've worked a little bit in pharma. Can you tell us right now your take on the state of pharmaceutical companies, Alzheimer's research, and where we stand?
Well, I was very fortunate because we were one of the first to help develop the first drug for Alzheimer's disease, which was a cholinesterase inhibitor. As you know, one of the chemical abnormalities associated with Alzheimer's disease is the lack of acetylcholine, which is believed to be a neurotransmitter that's important in memory-related processes. And so by designing a drug, for instance, that would inhibit the degradation of acetylcholine, one may improve the level of acetylcholine in the brain and help the patient's symptoms.
And so are you seeing similar results between veterans and NFL players or retired players?
There are symptoms that you can find in Alzheimer's disease that could also be present in CTE, for instance. Okay. In addition, if one looks at the brain of patients with Alzheimer's disease and CTE, there are similarities as well. In Alzheimer's disease, we see mostly senile plaques and neurofibrillary tangles. Whereas in CTE, it's mostly neurofibrillary tangles and much less senile plaques. And the distribution of these lesions may be different as well. For instance, the neurofibrillary tangles that are present in CTE are located mostly in the deeper layers of the cortex, which is not necessarily true in Alzheimer's disease.
Interesting. Okay. And so as we're looking into the future, of a lot of drug development is happening right now in R&D, Is there anything on the horizon that you're involved with or really excited about or you think is just very, very promising?
Yes, I'm excited about the fact that we are now attacking the processes involved in Alzheimer's disease, pathophysiology or mechanism. And that is, we have studies going on how amyloid protein is deposited in the brain and how neurofibrillary tangles are formed. As we know, the neurofibrillary tangles are made up of abnormal tau protein. Mm-hmm. So now there are studies that will allow us to measure quantitatively the amount of, or detect the presence of amyloid plaques in the brain during life, as well as the density, for instance, or the amount of tau protein during life.
It's very exciting and very,
exciting.
Promising.
Yes.
Well, I'd like to thank you for being on the show today, and we'd love to have you back. And thank you so much for all the information you provided about what's going on in your world, as well as veterans and the NFL.
Thank you for inviting me.
Thank you for joining us. Be sure to tune in next week.